Hello guys, as a part of V2E Sikshana program, I am delivering a lecture on computer networks and security subject. In that, we are dealing with the first module of your syllabus called as application layer. As a takeaway, in the previous lecture, I had one question paper on computer networks with corresponding to the application layer. We'll see one more question paper and we'll try to explain the logic and scheme and solution for the same. This was a previous question. In the previous session, we saw this question paper and had given the crystal clear scheme and solution and what are the steps you have to write. In this session, we'll deal with one more question paper of December 19 and January 20. And we'll see the first question without wasting the time. Which protocol can be used for fetching web pager? Explain its working with request and response message format. Okay, my dear students, the question is totally for 10 marks. Okay, so you have to write the answer with elaboration. Okay, so which protocol can be used for fetching any data from the internet world? We have to use a protocol called HTTP protocol. Okay, so the answer follows like this. And the subtag question is explain its working. We have to explain the working of HTTP protocol using request and message format, header formats. That is, using the header message format of HTTP protocol, we have to explain the protocol of HTTP. We'll see the scheme and solution, what the solution you have to write for the question. As I said, the answer for the question is HTTP protocol. And HTTP protocol stands for Hypertext Transfer Protocol, which is one of the finest protocol of application layer. If you want to download any data or you can upload any data either with the help of HTTP protocol. Okay, so basically HTTP protocol works with the help of client-server communication. If you want to send any request, you have to use a message format called as HTTP request message format. The message sent by the sender will be bombarded to the receiver, and the receiver processes the HTTP request message format, and he'll reply with request reply message, and that message is called as HTTP reply message. Basically, we have two important message formats in HTTP protocol. One is HTTP request message, and one is HTTP response message. For this basic explanation with the answer as HTTP protocol, usually they'll assign for 2 marks. And the rest of the 8 marks will be for 4 marks for HTTP request message format, and the rest of the last 4 marks for HTTP response message format. We'll see one by one. Basically, HTTP request message format consists of 4 entities. One is request line, followed by header line, followed by body line, and followed by entity body. Request line having a message with method followed by a space followed by URL, uniform resource locator followed by the space followed space can be used with the help of slash here and followed by the version followed by carriage return and left factoring. And the header lines, we have the header field name followed by slash followed by the value. And similarly, the blank line, if you don't have any data, there will be a blank line, the request in the request message format. And in the entity body, it will be blank initially. In the response message format, the entity body will be filled with the request what you had sent. I mean to say that the response data will be appeared in the entity body. Okay, so in this message format, CR stands for carriage return and LF stands for line field. And SP stands for space. Usually the space will be represented by slash in the request or response message format. Okay, basically the first field of request line called as method, we can have get method, post method, put method, head method and delete method. The get method is used when the browser requests an object with the request object identifier. Request object is identified in the URL field. The URL is the second field of request line. And the post method is used to the user is still requesting a web page from the server, but the specific content of the web page depend on what the user entered into the form fields. If the value of the method field is post, then the entity body contains what the user entered in the into the form fields. Okay, so the next method is called as put method. The put method is also used by the applications that need to upload objects to web servers. Whenever you want to upload any data or any objects, you have to use the put method. And we have also have head method, which is basically used to retrieve header information. It is used for debugging purpose. We have a last method called as delete method. The delete method allows a user or an application to delete an object or on a web server. Okay, so these are different methods we can have in the first field of request line, followed by URL, which specifies the uniform resource locator of the requested object. Okay, so the next important field, what we have called as version, this field represents HTTP version. I think we all know that HTTP can appears in two flavors. One is HTTP 1.1 and HTTP 1.0. And the next field is called as header line. You can see in the message format, the next field is called as header line. Header line, basically, we have the example we can have. The header line. Header line can be of host, followed by the connection, which is should be closed, and who is the user agent, Mozilla, I mean 5.0, and whether it accepted a request or not, accept request will be sent, and all this will be the there in the header line. The next important message format of HTTP protocol is HTTP response message format. Unlike HTTP request message format, we have different fields in case of response message format. Okay, we'll call the first line or first field of response message format as status line here. But in case of request message format, we'll call it as request line. The status line consists of version field, followed by the space, followed by the status code, followed by the space, followed by the phrase corresponding to the status code, followed by the carriage written and line field. Similarly, we have the header lines followed by the blank line and the entity body, where in which the actual data will be embedded in the response message format. Okay. So, for example, we can have the example here. HTTP is a protocol followed by 1.1 version, followed by the status code. Can example have 200, and we can have the status message as okay. Okay. And connection will be of closed connection, and on which date the data has been updated, on which server, and when the data has been lost modified, and what is the content of the length you have requested, and what is the type of the content. Okay, the status line has three fields: the protocol field, the status code, and the corresponding status message. Okay, the version is always can be have two versions, as I said already, 1.0 or 1.1. The status code can be have various version field, status code field, starting with 200 up to, we can have up to 500. 200 stand for it is okay, 300 with major problem, somewhat minor problem, 400 with a major problem, and 500 with abruptly stopped or it has been damaged. Okay, so 200 okay, request succeeded and the information is returned to the response. 301, requested object has been permanently moved, the new URL is specified in the location. Okay, similarly, we can have 400, we can have 404, we can have 505, and so on. As the message indicates, for 400 we have bad request, for 404 we have not found, for 405 we have HTTP version not supported. Okay, so this is status codes that can be used by HTTP response message format. Okay, and the corresponding phrase for the HTTP status code. Header fields consists of the server uses the connection. It can be of closed connection. Whether the client is going to request a message, so it should be closed, and that is going to close the TCP connection after sending the message. The date, the header line indicates the time and date when the HTTP response was created and sent by the server. Okay, the server from where you are accessing the data, that will be represented by the server field. Okay, an example, Apache web server. The last modified field, the header line indicates the time and date when the object was created and last modified. The content field, the header line indicates the number of bytes the object being sent. The content type headerline indicates that the object is in the entity body's HTML or whatever the type of text it consists of. Okay. So basically, this is what how exactly we have a HTTP request message format and response message format. You have to explain the request and response message format with an example. Why? Because the question is for totally for 10 marks here. Okay. I hope you got the logic how we have to write for the first question. Without wasting the time, we'll go for second question. Explain the services offered by DNS and also explain the DNS record and message format. Okay, as this also have 10 marks, you have to explain the detail or services of services offered by DNS. It will be for minimum for 3 to 4 marks will be there, and explaining the DNS record and message format consists of 5 to 6 marks we have. So we'll have the a solution here. Okay, and basically DNS, okay, domain name system. I think we had explained the details of this. You can refer my lecture, the initial lectures of the module number 1. And basically DNS, the people you had to find or remember the numbers. So every host is identified by the IP address, but remembering the numbers is very difficult for the people. And also the IP addresses are not static. Therefore, a mapping is required to change the domain name to IP address. So DNS is used to convert the domain name of the website to the numerical IP addresses. Okay, so the domain, there are various kinds of domain. We have generic domain, country domain, and inverse domain. .com or education domain, for example, .edu, and military domain, for example, .mil, and non-profit organization domain, for example, .org, and similar to commercial, we have .net, and all these are generic domains. The second type of domain we have is country domains. If it is India, it should be .in. If it is UK, it should be .uk, and so on. Inverse domain, if you want to know what is the domain name of your website, IP to domain name mapping can be done with the help of very famous, important command called as nslookup. Okay, if you have typed nslookup space any domain which you wanted to search, immediately it will give the IP address. Similarly, for the vice versa operation also. For this basic explanation of domain name system, they will be assigned with four marks, and the rest of the message format they're going to assign with rest of the marks. The DNS message format consists of these fields. Let me go one by one. The first field is called as identification field, followed by flag field, followed by number of question field, number of answer record field, number of authority or record field, and number of additional record fields. This of totally of 12 bytes, followed by question field, a variable number of questions. It might be 1 question, 2 question, and follows name and type of fields for query. And the next field is called as answer field, a variable number of resource records you can respond to the question. And the next field is called as authority field, available number of resource records you can have. Records for authoritative servers or authenticated servers you can have. And the last field is called as additional information, in which we can have variable number of resource records. Okay. As the first field indicates, the identification field, the first 12 bytes of the header section, which has a number of fields. The first field is a 16-bit number that identifies the query. This identifier is copied and into the reply message to a query, allowing the client to match the received replies with the sent queries. Okay. There are a number of flags in the flag fields. A 1-bit query or reply flag indicates whether a message is a query or a reply. If it is 0, the message is a query. If it is 1, the message is a reply. And the next bit is a 1-bit authoritative field is set to a reply message when the DNS server is an authoritative server for a query name. A 1-bit recursion desired flag is set when a client, host, or DNS server or DNS server desires that a DNS server perform recursion when it does not have the record. A 1-byte recursion available field is set to a reply if the DNS server supports recursion. In the header, there are totally four number of fields. These fields indicate the number of occurrences of the four types of data section that follow the header. The question section contains information about the query that is being made. This section includes one name field, contains a name that is being queried, and second field is a type field that indicates a type of question being asked about the name. In the reply from the DNS server, the answer section contains the source records of the for the name that was originally queried. The authority section, the last field, indicates the records of the authoritative servers. The addition section contains other helpful resource records. Resource records are nothing but the data that might be request or a response message. Okay. With a detailed explanation of this, with the DNS response or request message format, it will be having 6 marks. Okay. I hope you got the logic of this. For the 2 questions of the first module in the second question paper, I hope you got the logic. How to write the answer for that? I'll stop now. The second question I'll consider in the next session. Thank you so much. If you have any questions at any point of time, please contact me.